Welcome everyone, this is Plugin Fox, and today we are working with Geyser MC. If you don't know what Geyser is a really, really neat plugin that allows you to have Bedrock players join your Minecraft Java Edition players. So, if you just go to geysermc.org, you can come here and download the plugin. As you can see, so Bedrock can pretty much find the same server and join. It works like any other Minecraft world. You just have to have the IP address for them as well. So let's get started. So we'll go hit download. Download. So they have a lot of different editions. They have the Spigot Edition, the Sponge Edition, and the Bungee Cord, and the Velocity. We're just going to do Spigot today. So I'm going to download that, and then once I download that, give me one sec, I'm going to get into my Minecraft portal. Alright guys, I am back. So we are now in my Minecraft test server. So I'm just going to copy and paste this into the plugins file. There we go. And now all we have to do is hit start and watch it run. If you don't know what some of these plugins are, you can kind of go to the other videos we have. Otherwise, while this is loading up, if you guys have any other suggestions for videos, just leave them in the comment section. Or if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below too, and I would be happy to answer them. Next week at some point I'm going to try and release a Discord server for you guys. So if you guys are interested in joining the Discord, you can get some more tips and tricks, help talk with the community and all that stuff about different plugins and features. 100-chord server, but you can also do compression level stuff, so how much bandwidth it uses. You can name your servers with all this stuff, and then floodgate is another plugin that you can do with this as well. I'm going to try and cover this in a different video though. It allows you to be online while playing it. So most of your servers will have to be in offline mode if you use Geyser. What Floodgate allows you to do is be online. So it'll pull your skins, it'll pull from like the Minecraft database and make sure that your players are actually Minecraft users and all that stuff. You can set... So if you don't have anything else, this would technically be considered a bungee cord server in an instance. It is not actually a bungee cord server. But if you wanted to, this will manage everything for you. So you can set the max amount of players. You can set titles. You can set the message of the day, you can set all this through this one here, and Geyser would manage it all for you. And you can do like Nether and all these other plugin stuff as well. Some of the other stuff is, yeah, most of the stuff you probably won't touch. If this is just kind of a normal survival world, if this isn't a normal survival world, you might need to tweak a few settings just to kind of make it work. As I said, it kind of just depends on what scenario you have. For right now, for what I have, I'm just doing a normal survival world. If you guys want to see me do a bungee cord world with it, just let me know. And I can show you guys. So, with that being said, I'm going to jump into the world. Alright guys, I am back. So, we are going to jump in the server here really quick. So, now you can see that my Java account is in on my computer. But it pretty much looks the same as normal. There's literally no changes that have happened so far. So we are going to move over to my phone. And here in a second, you'll see my display. And this will allow you to connect. The only problem is with this, you can't do two devices at once. So if you're using a phone, you're not going to be able to use your computer at the same time, so it's going to be a little bit more tricky. Give me 1 second, now I'm going to join with my phone. All right guys, we are back in. So now you can see I'm on my phone doing it, and we're able to play Minecraft on the server. It was pretty easy to install. I am probably going to release a video about how to doing it on the bungee cord server. But if you guys, as I said, have any questions, just leave them in the comment section below. If you have any, or if you like the video, hit the like button. If you want to subscribe to see more, hit the subscribe button. Otherwise, I will catch you guys later and have a great rest of your day.